Name of our campaign shall be Hep-Talk. Primarily, yeah. So my group members are Shruti, Kratika, Parag, Tejaswin, Abhishek, Vaishali, and Rohit, and Shweta. So primarily, we'll be talking about the guiding principles. As it is said, they catch them young. So we try to create our target audience within the youngsters and the college goers who would be in the age of 18 to 25. Also, we have tried to create a preventive rather than a curative model because we think that that shall be creating a larger impact than a curative model. Other than that, so we'll begin with our presentation. Firstly, I'd like to mention that we chose a caricature which presents a guy instead of girl because that was a convenient one and we could get that, so no biases there. Firstly, we chose youngsters because youngsters, if you talk about college goers, they could create a larger impact by conveying the message to their family members, other people, their friends. So the impact could be exponential and could create a ripple effect. So here, if he gets married, so they can also talk about the maternal health with the woman so that it is not transmitted to the infant. Here, they can convey the message to the older people and the elder people in the families. Also, they could they could prevent the entire spread of the issue at a gamut of at various places, and it could have an exponential effect. To talk about the objectives, I would like.
So these will be our objectives. I mean, I'll just read them out because we have tried to make them as clear as possible. Early and timely detection of hepatitis B. We are focusing on hepatitis B because it has more chance of being sexually transmitted. And we'll be focusing on the college students, undergraduate and postgraduate students in Delhi University. Like Delhi, basically colleges in Delhi. So early and timely detection of hepatitis B. I mean, because if it's diagnosed young, it can be treated better. We can come up with a better treatment plan. Busting myths and taboos related to hepatitis. Prevention of sexual transmission of hepatitis B among youngsters by promoting safe sex practices. In our strategies, we will discuss how we are going to achieve these objectives. We are going to create leaders and responsible citizens of tomorrow, creating an action plan based on the interests of the young population, creating an exponential impact on the families of the youngsters. So while creating these objectives, we have tried to keep in mind a couple of things. We have tried to make a very focused model. We're not going to say that we are going to cure the problem completely by focusing on many groups. We are going to focus on college-going students, undergraduate and postgraduate students in Delhi, and then we'll see from there where the program goes. We have tried to, we'll keep this project running for 2 academic years because most of our activities, as we'll discuss in the strategies, will be focused in college fests and collaborating with people in colleges. So 2 academic years will be the running testing period. This will be the place of project across college campuses in Delhi. Our approach is preventive, proactive, and awareness and dialogue generating. Preventive because we are trying ki hepatitis B ho hi na, rather than coming up for ways to treating it we are trying ki ho hi na. So obviously safe sex practices, getting vaccinated, those will be our priorities. Proactive because we want to control the situation rather than waiting for it to happen and then finding a solution. As Shweta said, catch them young. A stitch in time saves 9. And awareness and dialogue generating. So like people talk about HIV. Everybody knows about HIV and AIDS. And both these problems are really big. So we want people to talk and know about HIV and hepatitis as much as they know about HIV, Next, I'd like to call Abhishek to talk about the contents of our IEC and our strategies.
So basically, the IEC materials which we will be developing will be catering towards countering the myths which is prevalent amongst the youth, also the modes of transmission through which hepatitis takes place, so that the myths and stereotypes and the stigmas related to the disease can be countered. Also, the options available, like we were told today, that even we didn't know that there are at least 5 nodal centers where people could get better treatment related to hepatitis. So all these kinds of information will be conveyed through the IC material. Next is our strategy. So basically, since we are targeting the colleges, so since we know that during the fest season, fests are celebrated usually in almost every colleges. So we'll be targeting fest. We will be also in collaboration through student union. We will try to ensure that the artists which are visiting colleges for performing, they also talk about these issues. Also, every college has almost developed this kind of culture of organizing speaker sessions, TED Talks, etc. So we could use even that kind of platforms for pitching ideas and spreading awareness regarding the issue. Also, obviously, workshop and seminars by experts like the faculties which are here from ILBS, to bust myths and taboos. Committing change makers for generating awareness on prevention of hepatitis B and C, handing out pamphlets at college fest by liver mascots. You know, fest is a time of, you know, enjoyment, and that's why mascots could also serve as an effective tool for gaining attention and then spreading information. We will be also tapping on various college societies like NSS, which especially focuses on carrying out social service. So we can tap on with NSS societies, college theater societies. Also, installing informative condom vending machines in college washrooms, screening booths where rapid diagnostic tests will be taking place at college events. Like, almost every college organizes its blood donation camp, but simultaneously, along with blood donation camp, if we start organizing hepatitis screening camps, so it could also prove to be a way forward for us. And carrying out treasure hunts and other enticing activities and competitions during college fest.
We have taken the idea of change makers from you and he for she change makers and commitment makers. So that has already happened during our undergrad years. So we already know that creates a lot of impact. And I being one of the change makers, so I know that we can get a lot of people to come for that. So that came from that.
Vishal, you want to do methodology? You want to do methodology?
Establishing communication channels with stakeholders via curated proposals, and another one would be to convincing stakeholders for collaboration, and third would be to chalking out common plans and strategies for both the parties, and another would be to implementing the desired plan with interactive and inclusive strategies. And the last would be to, keeping contingency plans ready for tackling uncertainty.
So basically, what we mean by saying establishing communication channels, since we are working with basically we are targeting college and college societies, institutions within colleges. So, paperwork also takes time. For even a small collaborating activity, you need to send out written formal documents, then it needs to be processed by their conveners, then it needs to reach out to the principal, and then the permission comes up, and then the event could take place. So by establishing communication channels, we meant to go ahead with this paperwork and convince stakeholders that these issues also need to be addressed and we need to talk about them. The plan which we will be chalking out for NSS won't be feasible for implementing with a theatre society or dance or drama society. So that's why we have discussed that chalking out common plans regarding both the parties, so that both the stakeholders get benefit and the issue gets addressed. And obviously implementing the desired plans, and then always there could be uncertain times at any point of time. So we always need to have a backup option in mind and contingency plans ready to tackle any uncertain.
I'd like to elaborate on 2 points here: interactive and inclusive strategies and contingency plans for tackling uncertainties. So what we mean exactly by interactive and inclusive strategies is that we do see certain caste and gender dynamics in colleges. So when we talk about creating an interactive workshop or an interactive seminar, we want everybody to be a part of it as much as they can, so that their gender or their caste does not come in between of how much they are a part of this process. And by meaning keeping, majorly what I feel the biggest uncertainty could be that, we are doing a rapid diagnostic test, and say somebody comes with a positive result, that they test positive for hepatitis B. So what do we do then? you know, so that will require a contingency plan where the people who are involved in this process will be acting as a support group for that person who is just who's just tested positive for something which will require lifelong management. So it's not just about creating a dialogue, creating awareness, but actually being there for somebody who got tested because of us and now needs our support. So both emotional and basically about emotional support as well. So that's our presentation, and I think that's where we'll conclude.